Hello everyone, in today's video we're going to be taking a look at how to fly the Pelican, this neat little aircraft that Microsoft released for free. For those of you who don't recognize it, this is the drop ship that came from Halo. We're currently sitting here at Block Island State, which in the last update they did some modifications to, which I'm kind of observing these modifications. I don't see the restaurant right here, I'm sorry. I've been down to Block Island enough time to see that. But let's go ahead and get started. So first things first, interestingly enough, we sit on the right for this one, which suggests we've got some kind of a helicopter kind of a thing going on. But it's not really that bad. One thing I want to do is I'm going to grab my throttle. I'm going to make sure it's pulled back. The reason I say to do that is because if I push the throttle forward, you see how the thing just hopped? Even though we're not on, we're still on. So that's kind of a neat little kind of... Was that a CD player? I don't know. It just kind of is. All right. So we're going to come down here. We have a bunch of different switches here. We got a master generator battery avionics. We're going to click all those things. If we needed to dial in our ATIS or anything like that, we could come over here. We have an engine info page. Notice everybody's at zero. We have our fuel page. Plenty of fuel. We probably take this thing around the world a couple times in the fuel. One thing you want to watch out for is when you're in here and you're swapping your frequencies. Obviously, when you click on them, you have to sit there and go, why is it not changing? Why is it not changing? The reason for that is because the numbers are down here. So, you know, if I do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, kind of a thing like that, 0, you'll notice that that dials in here. So you have to select the thing with your clicker to actually select the one. Obviously, you've got your navigation radios. We have no navigation here. So, like, for example, if I wanted to go up to Hartford, I could do 114900. And just like that, now I can select that particular destination. Notice, by the way, over on our radar, we actually have this little arrow now that tells us where we need to take this thing. So you actually can conventionally navigate this particular spacecraft, I guess is what I'm going to call it. So I'm going to turn on the beacon light, which is always useful to have. Obviously, we have our taxi lights. So we don't really have a conventional light for the purposes of saying, hey, we're taking off or anything like that, but that's good enough for us. So what I'm going to do now is obviously we have a radar map. You can see we can fly it to Hartford with all that arrow. We also have cam vision, but we'll get that one right in the air. Down here, you've got a bunch of different switches. And it's going to say inoperative to all of these switches. These switches don't do anything. However, if you come up here, these are where your system switches are. So for example, coming down here, I've got a cargo door button. You can actually push that switch and it'll open up the hatch in the back. I don't know what the maximum speed for the cargo door is, but having played the game, it must be pretty high. Let's see, we have a bunch of inoperative switches. Don't worry about them too much. Of course, we have fires and everything like that. One thing you want to watch out for in this one is this little switch that says landing. This controls what mode the whole spacecraft is in. If you're in landing mode, that simply means that you're going to be going up and down when you push the throttle. If you're in flight mode, it means you're going forward and backwards when you push the throttle. We'll see exactly what I mean in a minute when we go ahead and take a look at it. Down here in the middle, this is going to be your autopilot select. Be a little mindful about your autopilot selection here. Like, obviously, you know, if I want to change my heading, I can come over here. I can click and hold this, and I can go ahead and change the specific heading that I want to be traveling on. The autopilot's a little wonky at this stage, and I'm sure it's going to improve a little bit. All right, let's go ahead and get this thing started. So first things first, we have a bunch of fuel switches here. We're just going to click them to turn them on. I just rotate them 90 degrees to the right, and then we're going to turn on the two oxygens first. Again, that's just going to take care of a couple things for us. One thing, if we do want to change our thing, we can turn terrain on and off. We can turn on the weather if we need the weather. We have waypoint mode, so we can actually see all the different fixes around us. We can do airport mode. You can navigation aid. You can see VORs, and of course, traffic you almost always want to have. You can also change the distance on map. So if I want to zoom out a little tiny bit, I can make it a little bit easier. I can also change the angle, but we'll see that in a minute. None of those unfortunately work. All right, so our nav back one's good to go. I'm going to click on engine infos here. I'm going to go ahead and press 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. This is one of the simplest things I think I've ever had to start inside of Microsoft because, you know, there's not a lot to it. I'll swing over here real quick while I'm having some fun. I'll come back here. We've got some computer displays and things like that. Maybe fun if these work, but you know, it does work. Click. We can actually go in the back. Yes, I have a key bound that enables me to basically float around. So unfortunately, we're not carrying anybody today. If we were, of course, you know, I have the ability to kind of float back here. You've got all these like little things about, oh, we can fit a tank in here and everything like that. I'm like, I'd like to fit a tank in here, but unfortunately, this is a flight sim, not a tank sim. You got to go play Steel Beast if you want to go do a tank sim. All right, we'll back ourselves back out. I'm going to make sure we secure the aircraft or the spacecraft. I mean, click, click. And I believe our engines have spooled up. Yeah, you can see right now is all four of our engines are spooling up. Now, this aircraft, or spacecraft, is much, much more about just flying on slew mode than it is about, ooh, you got to be precise and hit the right speeds. There's a couple weird little quirks to it, and I'll show you exactly what I mean once we get a little closer. And for those of you who do have VR capabilities, try this out. You'll be tickled by how much it's going to make you puke. It's actually kind of fun. All right, our engines are good. We want to make sure we're on landing mode, which is the correct mode, because I have all my controls, just a quick little wiggle, make sure they're working okay, like this old school controller. So how do we taxi this thing? Well, it's a little trickier than that. When we are on this mode here, I'm going to switch back to synthetic vision. It's just easier for me. See this little thing on the side? This gives me my thrust relative. So when I push my throttle forward, You're noticing my thrust is coming forward, but the aircraft or spacecraft is not moving. When I put it right here in the middle, you see a little green zone. You see how we popped up a couple feet? This is neutral. So if I wanted to, for example, come forward in back routes, I could just go ahead and move my regular stick. And again, use your rudder pedals to point where you want to go. Consider this to be hover hold. So now if I reduce this just a teeny tiny bit, let's say I put it right here. See how nice and gentle that comes down. And again, I can pop it back up into center. I can push it slightly past center and then bring it back to the middle. And you can see it just sort of locks us in place. One nice thing is we do have a vertical speed display. So if once it's at zero, we're zero. We also, of course, can see exactly how far off the ground we are right now. So if you notice, I'm pushing my throttle forward, but nothing's happening. If I push it just past this, you see we're starting to climb? And then I can pull it back into the center to go ahead and hold it at the altitude. And we could sit here for a month without anything bad happening. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and press my right rudder pedal. Now, when I first flew this thing, I used to stand on the right rudder pedal like this. But if you do that, I let go of the right rudder pedal to go to what it does. You see how the whole thing just kind of keeps going? So I recommend kind of being a little gentle with it. Next thing we want to do, now that we're airborne, we're going to go ahead and slap our landing gear up. Again, we've got a little thing in the front. We have a couple little bars in the back. I think that's kind of a nice touch. So when you're in hover mode to steer, you just move your joystick and rudder pedals. So for example, I'm just going to do a little kind of, is this a hover taxi? I don't know what the technical term for that. I guess it's a hover taxi because I really am hovering. So I'm just going to come between here, like nothing too exciting here. This is still considered taxiing. And you can even see Microsoft's like, oh, did you want me to draw the blue arrows to let you know where you're taxiing? I was like, yes, Microsoft. I appreciate that greatly. Thank you. All right, we're going to go this way. Obviously, if you want to go faster, you just stick a stick farther forward, and you start going whoosh. And if you want to slow down, you just hold it back, and it'll slow down. You can actually pull backwards. You can even slew left and right if that's exactly what you want to do. Again, it's like driving a mech warrior, to be honest, when you're doing something like that. All right, so we're going to come up. We're going to check to make sure the approach is clear. It doesn't seem to be anybody on the approach today. Come up this way. I'll go ahead and use up the entire run. This is so awkward. We're going to come right back to the end of the runway here. There we go. I'm going to go ahead and do a 180. This is with my feet, by the way. Oh, too far. You're going to do that about 30 times with this thing. It's nice, but it does kind of get away from you. All right, we're ready for takeoff. All right, so how do you take off with this thing? Well, there's no book on this, so we have to kind of do it with what we know from the series. So we're going to tip the controller forward, and we're going to push the throttle forward at the same time. So what's going to happen here is we're going to start doing this kind of like a gentle kind of forward slew thing. And then what you do is you press your afterburner enable button, which is also going to go ahead and click that switch that says landing mode. And as soon as you do that, we're going to transition from takeoff mode to go, 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 go mode. And you're also going to notice that our little fans there are now pointing away from us. And now this handles like a very strange conventional aircraft. One thing you want to watch out for is it has a very, very, very easy speed limit to violate. You can see I'm doing about 350. If I were to push the throttle all the way forward, you're going to get an overspeed warning almost immediately. It doesn't like to go faster than 360 knots. Now, the next thing you're probably asking is, how fast does this thing go? It actually goes pretty darn quick. It has some kind of special jet engine, as far as I can tell. It doesn't handle like a rocket motor. It handles much, much more like a conventional jet engine, because as you get higher, you'll actually have significantly less thrust. One thing you probably notice is if you look over on my left display, we got a navigation display with a little pink line there. That pink line is there because before I loaded this spacecraft up, I actually, inside the flight simulator, picked the destination. If you don't do that, you're going to have a tough time doing it, unless, of course, you have like the GTN 750 or something, and you can just manually override that inside the sim. So what I'm going to do is give it full throttle, and we're going to go ahead and get ourselves a little bit of altitude here. When you climb at this thing, I find 45, 50 degrees is plenty. But usually what I do is I try to just kind of pin it at a constant climb speed. So I'm actually going to nose over here, and I'm going to try to get it to about that 350. Seems to be pretty sweet here. So come pop down a little bit. Notice I'm crossing 11,000 feet already. This thing is exceptionally quick for its size. Obviously, it's from the future, and it doesn't exist, but oh well. There we go. We got about 335. I'm just going to pitch up until we get just about 350 knots. That seems to hold it pretty well. By the way, there is pitch trim on this one, so you're definitely going to want to be using your pitch trim at all times. The angle of attack limiter is definitely present as well, but it's not nearly as aggressive as you've probably seen in some other places here. So we're just going to get it right to 20, give it a couple taps of trim, and this is how we make the thing go up. It's kind of neat in that sense. We'll go take a look at it from outside. We're just going. If you're wondering about range, so far, let's see how much fuel we burned. 4%. So we definitely have a limited range on this thing, but it's particularly high. You can see if it switches to pounds. We have a lot. Also notice what our payload capacity is insanity. But again, that's just part of the fun here. Someone probably worked out how much one of the Scorpion tanks weighed and said, yeah, we want that. It's like, okay. So now we're just going to hold this speed. I'll pull back just a tiny bit, and it's just kind of taking us up. You can see, like I said, we're about 27,000 feet already. This thing has a pretty ridiculous vertical speed. Not quite like, I don't know, we're getting up towards F-35 or even F-22 territory there, so it kind of doesn't surprise me in that regard. Now, you're probably saying, hey, I want to make this thing go fast. What altitude should I pick? You want to pick an altitude that enables you to maintain that indicated airspeed. So, like, if I let this nose come down, let me go speed up time just a little bit here. See, I'm holding that 350. Whoa. There we go. Again, I'm speeding up time here, so again, a little bit of reduction of frames, but nothing too bad. Notice as I'm holding this, my Mach number is slowly increasing, but my indicated airspeed is not increasing. So the only way to make this thing go fast is to actually go a little on the higher side than you probably expect it to go. There is definitely a limit where once you cross that line, nothing good is going to come about it, and you just won't be able to accelerate anymore. But you can see I'm about 50,000 feet, and I'm also pushing Mach 1.2. So that's pretty darn fast. Go ahead and press that a couple times, get us all nice and leveled up. Woo boy, this thing is a fun project to try to get leveled off. Activate the automatic pilot there, and you can see it immediately starts pitching up on you. If you press the altitude hold, it captures the altitude, but it doesn't actually engage the specific servos required to grab onto it. Now that's one of the things. Now if you want to see a really fun trick, watch what happens if you flip from flight mode to landing mode. Yes, we just stop. And now the nice thing about this is if you're up in space, which I know many people will probably try at some point. Now, yes, you can't get to space with this. It's just within the time we have in the video, I don't think I'm going to try to fly up into space. If you really want to go to space, just use slow and go straight up. Notice because I am now hovering, I'm no longer moving. So I'm just sort of chilling. Obviously, that's what a hover is. So you can actually pull the throttle all the way back and start a ridiculously high speed descent. You can see my descent rate here is coming up on 12,000 feet per minute. So I like to call this lunar lander mode. And the reason I call it lunar lander mode is for anybody who played that game way back in the day. You basically entered a certain amount of thrust for a certain amount of time, and you try to not run out of fuel before you touch the lunar lander. But notice we're dropping at, it looks like about 27,000 feet per minute now. Now you're probably saying, okay, now you're going to smack into the ground pretty hard. And I would agree with you completely on that one, because now in less than 1 minute, I'm going to be pancaked on the ground. I'm actually falling faster than, I don't know if I'm quite free fall speed, but you can see this thing is just dropping like a painful, painful rock here. Not quite like freeze fall, but we're definitely getting up there. And you can see again, about 45,000 feet per minute, we're starting to catch up a little bit of air, which makes sense because it gets a little bit thicker. So you're saying you're going to fix this, right? Yeah, I'll fix it. Don't worry. Just kind of cruising, you know, little journey to Nantucket in a futuristic spaceship. I'm sure they won't mind us at all. Obviously, we're in alpha airspace too, because we're over 18,000 feet. So what do we do? So a couple things we can do. First thing is that you can click on flight mode. Now, what is that going to achieve? Austin Center, generic. It's going to do this. And we pull back, and now we're done. That's it. Switch back to that mode, and you can see the spacecraft, despite the impending collision with the ground, was able to easily transition between those two different modes. Now, that's just another one of those kind of quirks. So now that we've had fun with that, let's go ahead and flip back to flight mode, and then we'll go find a nice soft spot to land here. Like I said, we're heading for Nantucket today, so we'll go visit Nantucket. That seems pretty legit. Woohoo! I love how the wing... Whoa! That's just cool. Remember, they got that limit of 360. If you're flying with damage turned on, you'll find that it will do damage to your spacecraft, so be kind of mindful about that. Also, it pitches up when you go really fast, so it becomes very difficult to control. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get us nice and low. I'll speed up time a little bit here. That's about 360, more than fast enough. Whoop, looks like we're picking up some traffic that was already here today. There we go. Speed's pretty good. Again, I'm basically gliding it in. There are no speed brakes on this, so unfortunately you don't have the ability to just click a switch and be like, haha, speed brakes. But it doesn't matter. We have a hover transition mode, which is more useful than speed brakes. All right, so we're just going to line up with the taxiway there. It's like November 22, November X-ray is now going up to, oh, I don't remember which one cow it is. Not too far from here. If they know, a JetBlue is on final. Poor guy, I'm about to cut him off in a spaceship. Hate it when that happens. Happened to me 3 times on Nantucket already. All right, I'm going to press transition. And I'm going to push the throttle right in the center. Pull back on the stick. And we're going to activate the landing gear. And we're going to land. Isn't that ridiculous? So when you're landing, I haven't found a maximum vertical speed that you can smack into the ground. Obviously, take your time. Like I said, I'd rather go land up by this Blériot, which kind of surprised me. All right, we're about 6 inches off the ground here. That looks a good spot right there. And go ahead and pull the throttle back. We're here. And that's it. Securing this spacecraft is relatively simple as well. It's just a matter of shutting everything off here. You can pop those two off. Get your two fuel valves. Obviously, that fuel, the engine's going to get really grumpy at you. Make sure you secure everything else. So when you're shutting down, we go click all our switches, pop them all off, and then we have a successful flight. Enjoy.